Hey guys, it's me Tyler again. I didn't make a video last week because I was actually sick and I couldn't really talk, so that's the reason I was absent. And today's video is going to be a what's on my iPhone 8 Plus. This right here is just my lock screen, and I got this picture off of Tumblr, and I looked up aesthetic photos, and that's how I found it. It's just a picture of a nice flower tree. And this is my home screen, the main screen, the first swipe you get. And it just has my basic things like my calendar, my photos, camera, email, app store settings, and stuff like that. I have one folder on here, and this is called the shit I don't use, because it's the stuff I rarely ever use at all, like voice memos, the compass, the home, and shortcuts. Then if you swipe right, these are all of my apps that I use. I have Instagram that I get on a lot. I have also add my Instagram. I have Snapchat that I use a lot as well. That I use mostly, actually. I get on this a little bit less than Instagram, but I do use it a lot. I have Messenger, which I rarely actually use at all. I don't really use it at all. Last time I texted someone on here was, April 27th. That was a little bit ago. I have Spotify, which I use to listen to most of my music. I don't have Spotify Premium, sadly, but whenever I want to listen to a specific song or listen to like a specific part on a song, that's whenever I use the next app called Trending, which my friend actually introduced me to. And on here, you can look up any song you want. So if I want to look up Shawn Mendes' new song, If I Can't Have You, look up, then, well, there's an app, but there's only like one app usually. But after I look up the song I want and I tap on it, it'll start.
Can't write one song that's not about you. Can't drink without thinking about you. Is it too late to tell you that everything means nothing if I can't have you? I'm in Toronto and I got this view, but I might as well be in a hotel room, yeah. It doesn't matter cause I'm so consumed, spending all my nights reading texts from you. I'm good at keeping my distance. I know that you're the feeling I'm missing. You know that I hate to admit it, but everything means nothing if I can't have you.
Load. I don't know if this is my video or not, but I guess we're about to see. Yes, this is my video. So you can look up any YouTube video you want, which is pretty cool. So it's kind of like having YouTube Premium, because you can play the videos and listen to them out of the app, which is really cool. And I like to use that, and you can make playlists, and you can look up playlists, which is really cool. So like if I want to look up top hits 2019, it'll have these really cool ones, and I'm actually going to save this playlist, and you can add it to your favorites, and it's just really cool app that I like to use a lot. My next app is the CW, and I use this to catch up on all of my main shows that I watch, because sometimes I'll get busy and I can't watch it the night it airs, which sucks because spoilers, you know. And I use it to watch all my main shows on the CW, like The Flash, Riverdale, Supergirl, and Arrow. Then the next app I have is called Tubi TV, which I don't really use that much. I just downloaded it to see what kind of movies and stuff it has, and to be honest, it sucks ass. Like, who's ever heard of Sharktopus versus, I don't even know how to say that, but it's just dumb. It has movies people's never even heard of. Alligator X, a giant alligator. Piranaconda, what the fuck is, okay, but yeah, it has really dumb stuff on there. I don't even know why I still have it, but I'm surprised it has normal shows like Duck Dynasty. But it has dumb stuff. It only has a couple good things. Like, if I go to horror movies, I know Paranormal Activity is a good movie. Paranormal Activity 4 is a good movie. And Pet, I think. But I'm probably going to delete that because it's dumb. I have Visco, which is a photo editing app that you can use to lighten pictures. And you can also discover ones that other people have made, which is cool. And you can inspire other people, and they can inspire you as well. Then I have Focus, which is another photo editing app where you can use any of your... It can only work on iPhones that have double lens, because it uses the... portrait mode. So if I was to tap on this picture, it basically lets you tap on any point in the photo and edit it, and you can adjust how blurry the background of the picture is. So if you want to be really blurry, you can adjust it on this thing, and then you can tap on any point. Like, if I want to tap on my face, it'll blur everything else. If I want to tap on this car behind me, it'll focus on that car and blur everything else out, which is pretty cool. Actually, you can adjust how blurry it is, which is a pretty cool thing to do. And then my next app is Huji Camera, which is an app. It's kind of like a retro camera app where it gives this cool effect onto your pictures, and it can put the date in the bottom. And my next app is the Walmart Money Card app, which I really use some of them, to be honest. I only had that because I had gotten a prepaid card to download Procreate to do my cartoons. But my next app would be TikTok, and I only use this app to look up funny videos.
Nice question.
Because TikTok is hilarious, to be honest. And that's all I really use it for. Then I have Duolingo because I wanted to learn Spanish, and I still do, but I plan to get on it, but then I forget, which I shouldn't, because Duolingo is going to come from me, his creepy little owl ass. Then I have WeHeartIt, which is the app I used to get the pictures for my intro and outro. And I go on it, and I would just look up Tumblr backgrounds, and that's where I found pictures like this. And maybe we'll see the pictures I actually used for my intro and outro one here if we keep scrolling. Maybe, maybe not. But if you're starting on YouTube, or if you just want a cool aesthetic picture, this is a really nice app. It's like Tumblr, but to me, I think it's a little better. The next app I have is Procreate Pocket, and I use this to make my cartoons. I'm just now getting back into it. This is one I'm doing right now of Emma Chamberlain. I just got done doing her skin with the shadows and highlights. This is the regular, oops, wrong, I did the wrong thing. This is the regular picture, and then this is it with, like, the coloring in. I still have to do the eyes, eyebrows, and mouth and stuff. But it's a really nice app. It's only $5, which is not that bad because it has so many options. It has literally, like, 10 or 20 categories, and each category has, like, 8 brushes in it, which is really... It's a really big category and variety of things for anyone in different styles. And I would really recommend the app if you're an artist on iPhone or iPad. Then I have Adobe Sketch, which I used before I had money to get Procreate. And it's a good app if you don't have money for Procreate. And I was able to do this on it, which is actually pretty good, and it's good for doing hair and stuff as well. It's just that this app, sorry I keep going in and out, but it's just that this app doesn't have that many brushes on it. It only has these brushes, but you can download different brush packs offline. Like, I downloaded, if I can find it, this one right here, my updated brush pack. It has 18 different brushes in it, so you can download different brush packs online if you want. And then my next app is Bitmoji, which I use to edit and update my Bitmoji because I recently got my hair cut. I know I'm gonna cry, but yeah, so now my hair is short, so I use that to edit my Bitmoji and change my clothes on him. Then I have my first folder on this page, which is my YouTube folder, and I have YouTube Studio, which I use to post my videos, iMovie, which I use to edit all my videos, then I have Photon, which I use to make my thumbnails, actually. Then I have Vilo, which is another app that I can use to edit videos, and you can use it to add text pop-ups and videos, which is pretty cool. And I have Glitch Video, which I used to make my first intro, but I didn't really like it, so I stopped using it. And I have PixArt, which is a photo editing app that I use just to edit some of my photos. Then I have a second folder called Education, and it's just like the basic stuff you use for school, like Brainly to get some of your answers, Photo Math to help you with math problems, calculator, and the measuring tool. And then I have Skinhead, which is just a thing I use to download Minecraft skins because I got Minecraft recently, which we'll see on the next page. And right now I just have the marshmallow skin, which is actually nice skin. Then I have JPay, which is an app that I use to send emails and pictures to my mom. She's in prison, and she's getting out soon, which is good, and she's gonna be going to rehab. But that's for another video. Then on my next, slide, if you scroll right, these are all of my games I use. And I have Hooked, which is an app. It's like where you read little text stories and you can tap on one, then slide up, oops, and you tap, and it's like little stories you can read, which is pretty fun and entertaining if I can even get out of it. It has lots of different categories, like you can go to the new ones, romance, horror, mystery, comedy. It has lots of different ones. My next app is Cooking Fever, which I used to play a lot, but haven't been playing it that much recently, and I'm actually pretty good on it. I forgot which one I was on, but you use it, and it's like those apps where people come to your thing, and they ask for something, and you're like, where it's better, and that's basically what you do. Then my next game would be BitLife, which is a little life simulator game, which is pretty fun whenever you're bored. And basically, whenever you open it, it'll have that little sperm, which is your life. And I already started this life, but if I will end it real quick, I'll show you what the starting page will look like. It'll have start new life, and then you'll have a name. Of course, there's an ad while I'm doing a video. But it'll have a... It'll have, like, a name, and you can age up whenever you want to. And you can make little decisions. Like, you can age up, and then each time it'll have, like, you have been diagnosed with cancer of the bladder. Wow, I'm 4 years old, and I've been diagnosed with cancer. Nice. But you can, like, go to activities. You can, when you get old enough, you can adopt. You can, go to casinos, you can do crimes, you can go to the doctor, move, you can do all kinds of stuff. You can get a freaking, if I can find it, you can get plastic surgery. This app is just really funny. And I would download it if I were you, if you're like bored and you don't have any games. And I have Flipmaster, which is kind of dumb.
The following game features trampoline,
but it's fun, I guess. When you first get it, it's fun, but after a while, you get pretty bored. You just try and get as many flips as you can. And you can get new flips, which gives you more points. And if you land on your head, you, like, die.
Game over.
Like, if I can land on my head real quick. Like that, you hit and then you die. Then you have to restart. But the next app I have, if I can talk, the next app I have is The Sims Mobile, which is pretty fun because I used to have The Sims 4 on my laptop, but it broke, so I had to sell my laptop and I wasn't able to play it no more. So this is the closest thing to it. Sadly. But I use this like almost every day because it's just really fun. And so far I'm on level 13. This is my house, just a nice little house, me and my roommate Kaden. Then my next app is called War Dragons. Or should I say my next game? I get confused. You have to stay with me. And basically, you're a dragon. You can upgrade them and stuff. And you burn down cities and gain coins, which is fun and a big mood. Then my next game is... excuse me. Or should I say, this is kind of like an app, actually. You use it and do little room designs. And when you open it, it's actually, I forgot to say, it's called Home Design or Design Home. And you just pick different things and there's challenges. And like, you'll tap on the couch again, pick which couch you want to put in the room. Like, if I wanted this light gray one with the black on the outside, it's 1599, and I only have 8000. So if I want to get that would use up all my a little bit of my money. And then there are ones you already have, like these ones at the top are ones I already have, so it wouldn't cost me anything to put them in there. And then you just design your little room however you want. And then whenever you're done, it'll be posted on their page and then people can vote on it. Like, my first couple rooms they got 4.14 stars, 4.32 stars, and 4.31 stars. And you can vote on different people's rooms. Then I have Pixel Shot 3D, which is a fun little kind of like arcade game. And you have this little ball, and you pull back to shoot it, and you have to get all the balls down. And what if a ball hits another ball, it makes that ball fall as well. And you have to try and get every ball, and you can get upgrades to where you have unlimited shoots like this. And you try and just get all the balls down, then you win that level. And then the next game I have is called Six, and it's basically a little like game where you try and get a high score each time. Right now my high score is 510, and you have this little shape. I think you can change it, but I'm not for sure. And you tap on the shapes under it to delete them, and you have to make it to where the shape on top doesn't fall off of the tower, basically. Like, if I was to make it unbalanced and this fell, I would only have a little amount of time to delete other ones, and then I would lose. And you try and get as far down as you can before you die. And then I have Our World, which is basically the Walking Dead version of Pokemon Go, which is pretty fun. And you can upgrade to different guns you have. You can have new people to fight with you. And see, right here, there's like some zombies right beside me. And if I tap on it, I can fight. And then while you're in here, you just tap to shoot. And you try and get headshots to kill them faster. Then you find people. You've, like, right now I rescued a survivor. And then there's like different events you can go to, and like if you look around, there's ones like this, and you have to walk towards them to get closer, and then you get more upgrades for guns and stuff. And then I have Roblox, which I play whenever I'm really bored, because it's just a funny game that I like to make fun of sometimes. And then again, there are some games inside there that are actually fun. Then I have Happy Wheels, whenever I'm angry and I want to play a violent game. And I like this game because, sorry, I accidentally hit the power off button on my phone, so the video stopped. But the next game is Happy Wheels, and I like this because whenever I'm mad, I can take it out on this game, because if I go fast, I can, well, if it'll work. I can impress people in it, which is fun to get out your aggression and stuff. Then my next game is called House Paint. And it's one of those games where you slide up and down and try and fill in all of the blanks. But in this version, it's you painting a house, and you'll hit play, and then you'll slide and try and fill in all the white with the paint, which is kind of fun. And you can do different levels, different, like, you can do it to where it's harder or to where it's more easy. I like the harder ones because it gives me more of a challenge. And then I have Fortnite, which is a pretty fun game. Everyone plays it. I'm not that good. I've had one victory royale, which is it. But I still like playing it whenever I want to have fun, I guess. And I have IMVU, which is kind of like The Sims, because you can create your virtual little character and go meet people. This is my friend. She made one on here because her phone died. But then the next game I have is called Wordscape. and you try and create words, you get daily rewards, like you, I just got one extra hint, and I'm on level 13, and you try and make words, and it gives you limited letters. I already have save, so it would shake that one, and since I have two hints, I can hit the light bulb. And now it had A up there, so A adds. And then that's basically it. Then I have Minecraft, which I play here and there. And then I have Episode, which is almost exactly like Hooked, which was the first game on this screen. But it's like a cartoon version. You can design your character and make different life choices. Then I have Flip a Clip, which I can use to make little like cartoons. This is my first one I had made. If I can go back to the beginning and I hit play. It's not that good, but I'm gonna try and do better ones in the future. Then I have Fruit Ninja, which I used to play literally on the daily whenever I was younger. I just got it recently, but if you haven't heard of Fruit Ninja, you've been living under a rock. I mean, no one really plays anymore, but this was the shit back in the day. You basically have this little blade and you cut all the fruit, but you can't hit the bombs or you lose. You can get upgrades to where you get different like blades that cut the fruit. And it has like different things like that right there. I can't hit the bomb or I'll get one strike. And if I get one strike, it hits the bomb, but it fills in one of those X's at the top. And if I get three X's in a row, then there. I forgot how this game works. I haven't played it in years, but that's Fruit Ninja. Then I have Perfect Tower, which is a fun game where you have this little like platform, and then you'll get a shape and you can drag it to wherever you want it to land, and you try and make your tower as tall as it can be, basically. And if it falls off, you lose. And that's basically all of my apps and games. And my back wallpaper is Cole Sprouse because, you know, he's hot. But I think I'm going to change it to Shawn Mendes soon because he got some new Calvin Klein picture recently. And they hot. But that's what's on my iPhone 8 Plus. I really hope you guys liked this video. If you did, like and comment and subscribe. It really helps me out. And I'll see you next week. Bye.